Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Sanika Inamdar, and this is my friend
Anushka Chaube, and we both are from the river Yamuna. So before starting our presentation, I just want to ask from you all that how many of you are the fan of Shammi Kapoor and the most popular song of Shammi Kapoor? Yes, absolutely correct. So I just want to make it clear that we are not going to give presentation on the Bollywood song, and we are going to give the presentation on the topic Downfall of Yahoo.
The main reason why we have selected this topic is because I think most of us, for the first time we got connected to the internet was through Yahoo. Most of us have had our first email IDs created on Yahoo. None of us in our wildest dreams have ever thought that Yahoo would have such a drastic downfall. So hence we have selected this topic for our presentation. That is the case study on the failure of Yahoo.
Audio. A place where time and space collide and breed wonder and joy and wow. Where news travels faster, friends come closer, and you go farther. Where you can consume, share, love, destroy, earn, flirt, watch and wonder in new ways. New ways. A place that will launch a billion worlds. A place shaped like you. Brought to you. Made by you. It starts with you. Starting today. Yahoo. It's you.
In our presentation, we are going to cover introduction, products, what went wrong, market share, revenue, and then we will sum up with the conclusion.
In the introduction, we have founders Jerry Yang and David Filo, founded in January 1994, headquarters in San Miguel, California, US. Area served is worldwide. Website is yahoo.com, and the type of site is web portal. Traded as Nasdaq Yahoo from 1996 to 2017.
There are many products of Yahoo, which includes Yahoo Research, Yahoo Music, Yahoo Lifestyle, Yahoo Mail, Yahoo Messages, etc.
Now, what actually went wrong? The first mistake was Yahoo confused being in the right place at the right time with being smart. So what happened was money came very easy for Yahoo. When the investors, when the internet was introduced, everybody was excited and so were the investors. So without giving it a second thought, investors invested in Yahoo, and thus Yahoo spent this money into buying ads for gaining traffic on their for their company. So what happened next was, during that time, the web portal of Yahoo dominated worldwide. So money came very easy for Yahoo. So this money, instead of spending carefully and creating an engineering culture, they spent it on buying more other companies like Tumblr and Broadcast.com, and they spent crores of rupees, around 600 crores on those companies, which later went into loss.
And this was the second mistake, that Yahoo forget what it was that got them there. They were distracted by their leadership and they lost many of their products, like Yahoo Search. It lost to Gmail Search, Yahoo Answers to Quora, Flickr to Instagram. And the most humiliating was that Yahoo Search, it lost to Gmail Search. So actually, as they lost, they had not taken initiation to cover that loss.
So the third mistake was, one of its founders, Jerry Yang, had made a smart investment. That is, it bought 40% of the company, that is Chinese e-commerce site Alibaba, for 100 crore rupees. Today, it's worth 20,000 crores. So what happened around 2012-14 was Yahoo sold most of its company which was under Yahoo during that time. And today, there is only 15% of Alibaba under Yahoo, and yet it earns around 6 times more than what Yahoo's core business is.
The fourth mistake of Yahoo was that Yahoo fell for CEOs who were not professionals. Within the 10 years, Yahoo changed the 6 CEOs. Marissa Mayer was one of them. Actually, she is considered as the best CEO because in 2013, the Tumblr acquisition occurs, and in 2014, there was the sale of Alibaba stock. So at that time, she had not taken initiation to cover that loss.
The next CEO, that is Scott Thompson, when he was made the CEO, the first thing he did was he kicked 20,000 employees, and whatever Alibaba share was under Yahoo, he sold most of it to create a bit of profit. Later, the company realized that he had lied and he was never a computer science engineer. By the time everybody got to know about it, he had already spent 130 days in the company, and the company had invested 730 crores on him alone.
The third CEO was Terry Samuel. Actually, he is considered as the worst CEO of Yahoo. Actually, during when he was the CEO of Yahoo, the Yahoo has got the second opportunity to acquire the Google, but he has failed to take that position.
The last and the greatest worst mistake was when Larry Page and Sergey Brin approached Yahoo to sell their web portal which they had created called PageRank, which today we know as Google, for 10 lakhs. Yahoo refused. Yahoo refused because they wanted their clients to be exposed to their own banner ads. They refused. They failed to understand that their company would grow and would grow better if their users get a better chance to express themselves. So they only thought about their own company and not their users.
So this is the revenue comparison of the year 2018 between Yahoo and Google. In 2018, the revenue was rupees 517 crore of Yahoo, whereas of Google, the revenue was 11,600 crores.
This is the market capital comparison. Market capital for Yahoo globally was 4,400 crores approximately, and for Google it was around 4,562 crores. So this is the search engine market share of India. Google, the total percentage of Google searches is 98.12%, and Bing is 1.21. So we can see how much Google, Yahoo has fallen down, that it is hardly 0.57%.
Now coming to conclusion, know your mission and focus on your capabilities. Form a strong culture with the best people, as we have seen that CEOs have now taken initiatives. And last, capitalize on shift on user behaviors. Thank you.